Hi, I'm Joost from BiteMyBun.com, and today I want to look at Japanese hibachi versus a teppanyaki style of grilling. Japanese has blessed the world with a lot of innovations, no doubt. In the world of food, they have really earned their place. Two of the most recognized Japanese cuisines are teppanyaki and hibachi. Just because these two cuisines have their origins rooted in Japan, many people make the mistake of thinking that they are the same thing. That is so not the case. Teppanyaki and hibachi are two completely different cuisines. Each has its own unique properties that make them stand out, and also they both have a different history. In this video, I'll clarify your confusion regarding the differences between teppanyaki and hibachi, and you can read everything in the article below. Now, what is teppanyaki? Teppanyaki is just all over the world nowadays. At this point, you must be wondering what it is, at least enough to know the differences with hibachi. Now, in layman's terms, teppanyaki is a Japanese cuisine that involves the use of an iron griddle to cook food. When we break down the Japanese word teppanyaki, things get a bit interesting. Teppan means the iron plate, whereas yaki simply means grilled food. You must be thinking that this is a very simple cuisine, but you would be very wrong. Teppanyaki is one of the most complex forms of food out there, and it takes high levels of skill to master this form of cooking. Teppanyaki has a very interesting history. I'm sure the first thing that comes to mind when thinking about Japanese history is that it probably involves samurais and sword fighting. But that certainly is not the case with teppanyaki. The origin story of teppanyaki is very similar to that of Colonel Sanders' story. Teppanyaki originated in Tokyo, Japan, at a restaurant chain called Mizono. When in the Kobe district, this restaurant first adopted the concept of teppanyaki in 1945. This makes teppanyaki a relatively new addition to the world of cooking. The interesting thing about teppanyaki's history is that the locals didn't fancy teppanyaki at all. Teppanyaki was criticized for being inappropriate and also unhygienic form of cooking. So you must be wondering how such a badly critiqued cuisine survived the test of time. It was, in fact, first American soldiers and later the tourists who adored this cuisine, especially people from the US. But the catch was that the tourists were mainly fascinated by the entertainment factor involved with teppanyaki. And by entertainment, I mean all the knife throwing and the playing with fire involved. Mind you, these require high skills. So Mizono took advantage of this and for the following years focused mainly on these entertainment factors. They hired people with excellent knife skills that were not hard to find in Japan. All those juggling with knives and ingredients, the risky maneuvers with the intense hot flame, they all paid off. Teppanyaki blows over to Western culture. Now, teppanyaki was a huge hit in Western culture, and soon restaurant chains focusing on teppanyaki were being opened up worldwide. Although many people call this type of cooking where the chef cooks in front of you on an iron grill plate, hibachi style cooking. Hibachi and teppanyaki are often thought to be the same thing, but this is a huge misconception. This is because they are both two completely different things. Hibachi is a Japanese word that translates to fireball. Hibachi is like a round stove that uses charcoal for cooking. Now, hibachi is not a newcomer in the culinary world like teppanyaki. Hibachi is believed to have been around for hundreds of years, tracing its origin back to ancient Japan. Hibachi cuisine is very easy to make, mainly because the hibachi grill requires little or no skill to operate. It is believed that hibachi first came to the scene when the Japanese were beginning to use metal in their cookware. Still, there are indications it was invented even earlier, around 79 to 1185 AD in the Heian period, and the first grills were made of cypress wood lined with clay. Hibachi, due to its simplicity, became one of the first contributions by Japan in the culinary world. Very soon, hibachi was mixed with rich Japanese culture. Hibachis were heavily decorated and they are often made part of Japanese rituals. Hibachi style food is the grilling of meat, seafood, and also vegetable dishes on a very hot cooking surface that sits on top of a ceramic or wooden bowl filled with burning charcoal. The Binchotan type of charcoal gives it its unique flavor. Now, hibachi was mainly used for heating a house, but as time progressed, the use of hibachi grew and became very diverse. It was even used for cigarette lighting. During the World War, hibachis were used by troops to cook their food on the battlefield. This shows how much deeply rooted hibachi is to the Japanese culture. In fact, before World War II, hibachi was the most common cooking tool used by the Japanese. It was very common to spot a hibachi in public places like train stations, bus stops, and hospitals. They put charcoal on it and then cook their food in it. For teppanyaki, as we know already, an iron grill is used. Now, the ingredients of teppanyaki and hibachi are likely to be very similar, which is perhaps one of the reasons that this confusion arises. Japanese shichirin grills are used for hibachi cooking. While the term hibachi translates to fireball, it actually means the stove for heating your house. When it's intended for cooking, the name shichirin is used. The grill used for hibachi cuisine is unique, an open-grade cylindrical vessel with fireproof lining, which uses charcoal as the heating source. So maybe the most well-known example of the confusion is about Benihana hibachi. Although people call Benihana hibachi style cooking, the cooking in front of you on the iron grill plate is actually teppanyaki. Benihana does offer some hibachi style dishes you can choose from, but the main attraction and the show you witness is teppanyaki. And that's it. Hope you like this video. I have another great video for you about teppanyaki and precisely what it is. You can watch that over here. Also, subscribe to hear more from us at bitemybun.com or search Google for Bite My Bun Hibachi for all of our information on the topic. I've been Joost, your host, and thanks so much for watching us.